With model SVP250, Seiko presents a new mechanism for dividers and glass doors which allows panelable or parking doors to be projected. This type is characterized by the stopping area for the panes that make up the product and offers multiple options, making it flexible and capable of being adapted to any space or installation requirement. The SVP250's function is to cover and separate large spaces and is suitable for both indoor and outdoor use. To ensure its correct installation, there follow details of the fitting procedure, both for indoor and outdoor enclosures. The first thing is to determine the light space we wish to cover. The contractor or final customer will decide the number, type of panes, and the parking to be installed for this space. This product allows us to install panes from 60 to 120 centimeters. The number of panes will be determined by the designer's design requirements and the light space to be covered, as well as the suitable type of parking to install. The panelling possibilities for the SVP250 are parallel parking, where the sliding panes are stored parallel to the main guide, and perpendicular parking, where they are stored perpendicular to the main profile. Depending on the needs of the installation, a determined number of swinging panes will be installed. The information set out in the documentation or in our technical office will need to be consulted in order to determine the widths of the pane, the swinging door, and the recommended parking. Once these have been determined, the installation can proceed. Fit the top profile, having first fitted the wheels and brake stops in position. We use wheels with ball bearings and straightened runs that ensure that the pane slides smoothly and silently. The versatility of the crosses and bends that the Seiko profile offers allows us to install the type of parking chosen for each installation. This mechanism is characterized by the panes being secured by means of anodized aluminium clamps without the need for drilling. We have two types of pane, central panes and swinging panes. Firstly, let us turn our attention to the swinging pane. For the top clamp, take one side of the clamp and fit all its components as shown in our documentation, the tightening screws and the pivoting mechanism. Next, fit the opposite side of the clamp, insert the pane into the clamp and secure the tightening screws with an Allen key. The bottom clamp will be a repetition of the previously described process, but with a number of different components, such as the rotating support mechanism, which determines the rotation point once the swing pane has been installed, and the locking mechanism, which will allow the pane to be locked with a key. Next, fit the pane in position, securing it with the top profile pivot, and then insert the bottom clamp mechanism into the pivot set into the floor. And finally, use the adjustment system to adjust the distance between the profile and the floor. In the case of the central pane, begin by fitting the top clamp. Take one side of the clamp and fit its tightening screws. Next, fit the opposite half of the securing clamp, insert the pane into the clamp, and secure the glass using the tightening screws. With the bottom clamp, repeat the same process, inserting the tightening screws and also the locking pivots. Once the clamp has been fitted to the glass, this pivot will allow the pane to be locked to the floor using the previously fitted floor locking device. Fit the securing plate to the clamp and then fit the central pane, securing it to the top profile wheel. Use the Seiko key with the adjustment system to adjust the distance between the profile and the pane. Moving the panes in the parking position, the required distance between one wheel and another is adjusted. Next, secure the wheels to the clamp using the securing plate screws and nut. Finally, fit the trim strips to ensure that no mechanized parts are visible, and fit the draft excluders to the top and bottom clamps of the central and swinging panes to achieve a perfectly airtight installation. We shall now show the various alternatives for installation. Parallel parking with the panes parked to the right or to the left of the installation. The number of panes can be limitless, and the swinging door is optional depending on the installation. Parallel parking moving the panes to the right or to the left of the installation. The number of panes is limited and the swinging door is recommended. Perpendicular parking to the left and parallel to the right. The panes will be parked on both sides and the swinging pane is optional. Perpendicular parking, moving the panes to the right or to the left of the installation, parking the panes in the desired place and with the swinging door recommended.